Hello and welcome to part 2 of the syringe engine build. Having made the barrel holder, I needed a way to hold the plunger of my syringe. Somehow, the 4 inches of door handle that I had left over from part 1 had vanished. Maybe it had rolled under the bench, maybe it had gone in the bin. Either way, I couldn't find it. That just left me with what was left over from making the barrel holder. It was barely long enough, not really enough to grip. After truing up with the bearing tool, I faced the end and reduced the diameter to that of the cone rod, keeping the cuts nice and light to keep it from flying out of the chuck. I drilled the centre to take an M4 screw and then cut a recess to accept the end of the syringe plunger. The rest of the process was more or less identical to that of the barrel holder in part 1. There was a move to the mill followed by making up an end cap from another gas regulator washer using a click spring superglue arbor and a collet chuck. There was drilling, there was tapping, and there was fitting M2 screws. Back on the lathe, the end cap was trimmed to size and its centre hole was opened out. Once cut from the parent stock, the rough end was tidied up. And this is how these parts fit together. I forget where this little motor came from, it might have been some kind of printer mechanism. Anyhow, the next job was to make some brackets to mount it. I decided to make these from a worn out peristaltic pump. After years of service, the plastic gears lose their teeth and the whole thing gets replaced. I always try and save the rectangular gearbox casings though. I'm not sure what the material is, it feels harder and stiffer than aluminium. It kinda looks die-cast, it reminds me of Eddystone project boxes if you've ever done any electronics. Anyhow, whatever it is, it machines well and I've made all sorts of little brackets and fixtures with it. Keep some of my die chem in an old nail varnish bottle. The little brush is better suited to small parts and it's less of a disaster when it gets knocked over. I marked out the centre, ready to make a 10mm hole to accept the motor boss. Next, I prepared yet another superglue arbor. The bracket is thicker than the motor shaft is long, so I needed a recess. A 1-inch end mill would have made short work of this, but I don't have anything that big. Once the glue had dried, I cut a recess the same diameter as the motor body. Next, I need to drill the mounting holes. Now, my trig isn't what it used to be, so it took a fair bit of googling about circumcircles to figure out how to get from 3 15mm centres to drilling coordinates. It worked surprisingly well, even with my cheap Chinese DROs. A tickle with a blow lamp releases the bond, and then a clean up with some acetone removes the excess glue. I wanted to take the sharp corners off the bracket, so I turned up a bush from a scrap of steel tube to use as a filing guide. All that remained was to drill a couple of fixing holes and the motor bracket was finished. Although a bit overkill, I wanted to use bearings on the barrel holder bracket. These were rescued from a scabby old stepper motor. Bearings are 16mm OD, which I suppose I could have bored out, but I decided it would be quicker and easier to use a selection of drills, mills and reamers. decided to round the top off, just like the motor bracket, so everything looked the same. This time, the filing guide was made from the stainless steel roller taken from the peristaltic pump. The last job on these parts was to trim them to length and drill a couple of fixing holes. Join me in part 3 when I'll be making the motor drive wheel and an intermediate drive arm.